Approximating Multiplications. Visit apscourses.com for more online courses. Let's have a look at the topic that we'll learn in this video. We'll learn how to find an approximate value for complex calculations. So, if we have to multiply 247 by 768 and I need the answer to the nearest 1000, that is, I need an approximate answer, not the exact answer. I need to follow the methods given in this video. This is the index. We'll read two separate methods, the one up one down method and the one up n down method. The one up one down method is a subcase of the one up n down method. Let's start with the first method, the one up one down method. This method is used when the numbers are close to each other. In this multiplication, 47 multiplied by 61, you can use the one up one down method. The ratio of the two numbers should be approximately 1:1. In this multiplication, for example, 47 multiplied by 61, the ratio is approximately 1:1.3. So we can consider this to be approximately 1:1. This method can definitely not be used when the ratio of the two numbers is 1:2 or 1:3 or 1:4 or anything of that sort. Let's take an example to understand the one up one down method. Find an approximate value for 34 multiplied by 47. The first thing to check is the ratio is 1:1 for the two numbers. The numbers are nearby. We can apply the one up one down method. In step 1, just have a look which of the two numbers is closer to any multiple of 10. 47 is 3 away from 50 and 34 is 4 away from 30. Therefore, 47 is closer to a multiple of 10, which is 50. So this is step 1. Just identify which of the two numbers is closer to a multiple of 10. Step 2, you convert 47 to 50. How do you convert this? You add 3 to 47, you get 50, and then you perform the reverse operation on 34. So if you are adding 3 to 47, you subtract 3 from 34. The two new numbers you get are 31 and 50. Multiply the new numbers, 31 and 50. You get the approximate answer as 1530. The exact answer of 34 multiplied by 47 is 1598. So you get a roundabout answer as 1530. So when you start this calculation, you need a closest multiple of 100 or say in a difference of 50. You can say to yourself that the answer is approximately 1500 or of that sort. Let's have a look at the steps involved in this one up one down method. You have to find an approximate value for x multiplied by y. You find out which of the two numbers is closer to a multiple of 10 or 100 or 1000 or whatever. You change one of the numbers. If x is that number, you change x to that multiple of 10 by adding or subtracting some amount to x, and you perform the reverse operation on y. And then you multiply those two new numbers to get the approximate value. Take another example now. Find an approximate value for 67 multiplied by 88. Is closer to 90. So you add 2 to 88 and you get 90. Similarly, you subtract 2 from 67 by performing the reverse operation on the other number. The two new numbers are 90 and 65. You multiply those two new numbers and you get the answer as 5850. Therefore, the approximate answer would be 5850. The exact answer is 5896. So you get a roundabout answer for this multiplication. Another example now, this time a larger number. Find the approximate value for 323 multiplied by 418. This time the numbers are again close to each other. The ratio is approximately 1:1.3. 418 is closer to 400. So convert 418 to 400 by subtracting 18. You subtract 18 from 418 and you perform the reverse operation on 323. So you add 18 to 323. You get 341. Let 341 be 340. Multiply the two new numbers now. You get the multiplication as 136,000. Therefore, the approximate value is 136,000. The exact answer is 135,014. So you get a decent roundabout answer. Find an approximate value for 3216 multiplied by 2589. This is an even more complex calculation. The numbers are roughly in the ratio 1:1. So you can apply the one up one down method. Since 3216 is closer to 3000, you convert 3216 to 3000. You subtract 216 from this number and then you perform the reverse operation. That is, you add 216 to 2589 to get 2805. You can let 2805 be 2800. Multiply 2800 by 3000. You get the answer as 84 lakh. Therefore, the approximate value would be 84 lakh. The exact answer is 83,26,224. So you get a reasonable value to work with. Let's take the next method now. The one up and down method. This is a more general method. This method can be used for any two numbers. Not in the special cases when the numbers are nearby each other. The ratio of the numbers is 1:n. The value of n can be anything. It can be 1, it can be 2, it can be 3, it can be 10, it can be 20, it can be 35, it can be anything. So whenever you are multiplying two numbers in any ratio, you can use the one up and down method. This is a much more powerful method than one up one down method. The steps are quite similar. You add or subtract an amount from the smaller number this time. In the one up one down method, you could choose any of the two numbers to add or subtract for the first time. However, in one up one down method, you add or subtract an amount to the smaller number only. And then you perform the reverse operation n times to the larger number. Let's take some examples to understand. Find an approximate value for 31 multiplied by 86. The ratio is roughly 1:3. Step one is, which is the smaller number? 31 is the smaller number. So change 31 to its closest multiple of 10. The closest multiple of 10 is 30. So you subtract 1 from 31 to get 30. In step 2, you perform the reverse operation. Since we subtracted 1 from 31, we'll add 3 times 1 to 86 to get 89. Why did we multiply it by 3? Because the ratio is 1:3. The two new numbers are 30 and 89. You multiply them. 30 multiplied by 89 is 2670. Therefore, an approximate value for this multiplication would be 2670. The exact answer is 2666. So this is an excellent approximation for this particular multiplication. Let's move on to the next example now. Find an approximate answer to 83 multiplied by 618. This ratio is roughly 1:8. You could also have taken 1:7. It doesn't really matter. The step one is change 83 to its nearest multiple of 10. So you can convert 83 into 80. How do you do this? You subtract 3 from 83. In step 2, you perform the reverse operation on 618 and you add 8 times of 3. 618 plus 24 would be 642. You can let 642 be 640 since you are obviously looking for an approximate answer. Multiply the two numbers together. 640 multiplied by 80 is 51200. Therefore, an approximate value for this multiplication, 83 multiplied by 618, is 51200. The exact answer is 51294. Let's move on to the next example now. Find an approximate answer to 374 multiplied by 2154. The ratio looks roughly 1:6. Step 1, you change the smaller number to its nearest multiple of 100. Change 374 to 400. In step 2, you perform the reverse operation on the larger number. So, since you are adding 26 to 374, you subtract 6 times 26 from the larger number to get 1998. Let 1998 be 2000. Multiply 400 and 2000, you get 8 lakh. Therefore, an approximate value for this multiplication, 374 multiplied by 2154, is 8 lakh. The exact answer is 8,05,596. Next example now. Find an approximate answer to 3439 multiplied by 67287. The first thing to do is look at the ratio. It looks roughly 1:20. The ratio is approximately 1:20. Step 1, change the smaller number to the nearest multiple of 100 or 1000 or whatever you are comfortable with. I am more comfortable with 3000. So I subtracted 439 from 3439. I got 3000. Step 2, perform the reverse operation on the larger number. Since you subtracted 439 from 3439, you add 20 times 439 to this larger number and you get 76,000 approximately. Multiply 3000 by 76,000, you get 228,000,000,000 as your approximate answer. The exact answer is 231,399,993. So you get a reasonable answer.